Hello. Well, we're going to have a look at a number of examples of seeing whether a given infinite series converges or diverges by using the ratio test. You use the ratio test when dealing with problems that involve exponentials, such as 2 to the k, or in some of the later examples when you've got factorials. Ratio test tends to work really well in those two cases where you've got factorials or exponentials. So in the first one, we're looking at sigma k squared on 2 to the k. So we're looking at an infinite series, and we want to know, does this converge? That is, do the partial sums approach some finite number as we take more and more terms in the series? So I'm going to, just to get the notation going, I'm going to let a sub k be k squared on 2 to the k, and we're going to use the ratio test. So in the ratio test, we're going to look at the ratio of of two successive terms, so a sub k plus 1 over a sub k. So where you see k, you copy k plus 1. Where you see k, you copy k plus 1. That takes care of the numerator. Now, rather than have double-decker fractions, I'm going to invert and multiply at this point. So I'm going to have, instead of having it over here, I invert and multiply and write 2 to the k over k squared. Now, the next step in using the ratio test is we've got to try and simplify this before we take a limit as k becomes very big. So I can see I can cancel out a lot of the 2s, so I just get a 2 here, and I get a k squared, and on the top I've got k squared plus 2k plus 1. And simplify a little bit more, I can divide by the highest power of k in the denominator, which is just a k squared, and so I get 1 plus 2 over k plus 1 over k squared, all divided by 2. So the next step is to see what is happening, to this as k gets very large. So we take a limit as k goes to infinity. We can see those terms are going to go to 0, so I'm just going to get a half as k goes to infinity. Notice the steps you write in. Put some English in, explain what you're doing. You're taking a limit of this ratio. And now, once you've got the limit of the ratio, the test says that if this number in absolute value is less than 1, then the series converges. If it's bigger than 1, then the series diverges because the terms are getting bigger and not smaller. And if the ratio equals 1, well, bad luck. The test doesn't work and you've got to try something else. So this one is a half, which is less than 1. So we can say that the series converges. The series converges by the ratio test. So that's a nice, fairly simple, straightforward example of where to use the ratio test and how it works in practice. I'll leave you to do number B is done very similarly, so I thought I'd skip to number C in this these problems. So in this one, we're looking at sigma of k factorial over k to the power k, where k goes from 1 to infinity. And this one is much harder, or somewhat more difficult. It's somewhat more tricky. But again, you've got factorials and you've got exponentials, so it really lends itself to using the ratio test. So again, we let a sub k be equal to k factorial over k to the k. And I'm going to look at the ratio of a sub k plus 1 over a sub k. Now, the simplification here is going to be a little bit more complicated. So where you see k, you copy k plus 1, so I get k plus 1 factorial over k plus 1 to the k plus 1. And then again, I'm going to invert and multiply, so I'm going to get k to the k over k factorial. Now, I've got to watch the simplification here a little bit. The first thing I want to do is I can cancel out a bit of the factorials. And so I can, this is really k plus 1 times k factorial, and so I'll get a k plus 1 over k plus 1 to the k plus 1, and I've still got a k to the k sitting there. So be very careful how you cancel. This is k plus 1 times all the numbers less than that, and that cancels out. And I can cancel out this with one of these, and so I'm going to get k, and I'll get both of these then to the power of k. So just note that step. I cancel out one of the k plus 1s. I then have a k to the k on k plus 1 to the k, and I'm going to bring them all under the same power k. Now, in one of the earlier problems, you will have seen the limit of this one. It's a little bit of a trick here, and that is the idea is you write this upside down, turn this upside down and write this to the power minus k. And when you turn it upside down, you get 1 plus 1 over k. And that might be a little bit more familiar to you, because you know that the limit of 1 plus 1 over k to the plus k goes to e, and this one is going to go to e to the minus 1, or 1 over e, as k goes to infinity. So just note that step. That's one of those standard limits that we have done earlier on in the course, and you would have done it back in earlier courses as well. Now, how big is e? Well, e is about 2.7, so 1 over it's going to be less than 1. And so therefore the series converges by the ratio test. Now, by the way, of course, none of these tests tell us what the series converges to. That is a much more complicated problem that we don't really deal with here. We're only interested in whether the series converges. Finally, so number D is sigma 5 to the k over 2 to the k plus 4 to the k. K goes from 1 to infinity. Now, always in mathematics, you don't just jump in and mindlessly apply algorithms. You think a little bit about what this series is doing. You'll notice in particular, you've got a 5 to the k on the top, which is going to be getting much bigger, much more quickly than the 4 to the k or the 2 to the k. So when I look at this, I think to myself, well, hang on a minute, this, in order for any series to converge, the general term must be getting smaller. It's got to be going to zero as k goes to infinity. And this is looking a little bit funny here, because it looks like the top is growing far more quickly than the bottom is. And so I wouldn't use the ratio test on this one. What I would do is I would look at the general term again, and I'd try and simply show that the general term is not getting small. And so I'd say something like this. In the denominator, 4 to the k is bigger than 2 to the k. So when I'm dividing by it, I can replace the 2 to the k with a 4 to the k and say this is bigger than 5 to the k on 2 times 4 to the k. Just note that step. I'm saying 2 to the k is less than 4 to the k, so in the denominator that's going to be bigger than 4 to the k. And now I can write this as 1 half times 5 quarters all to the k. And now notice that this number clearly is getting very big, so this is going to infinity as k goes to infinity. In other words, so the general term is not going to zero. And therefore, we can say that the series diverges by the nth term test, or the kth term test, which is the first test you always use when looking at an infinite series. You ask yourself, does it look as though the general term is going to zero? If it's not going to zero, the series can't converge, full stop. And so that's what I'm using there. You might like to try also doing it by the ratio test and showing that you'll see a similar thing happening, that the ratio of successive terms just gets bigger. But this is a slightly alternate way of doing it, which you should always be thinking about with these infinite series, to check that the general term is going to zero.